I was thinking of this in my brain, I'm like,
during
state of instability. You have notes,
I can take some.
During set of stability. Someone in the writing is not so. You want to recall, you want to sound recall, you want to rap, however you want it to be good. I believe in all the work that we serve in our pride. Hello? Class, are we communicating? You know what praying is all about? And you are seeing the different types of praying. There are so many types of praying. The grace of God, I'm privileged to be operating so many types of it as well. Yes, yes, yes. You know, the day you stop praying, you start what? You start dying. They knew I was working before, and before I now changed again, because I upgraded myself, I refused to be stagnant. And even till now, we are still upgrading ourselves. Like when I was in school, I remember very well my secondary school teacher precisely, who led teaching into politics. And today, he's very big in politics. Are you getting that? That's what life is all about. It's not because, okay, I've learned my queen, I'm going to stop here. You should know that things. I'll give you a one recipe about what this company will do, what they do. He said, we four of us applied for a job and we took two people. Some person believe that prayer is good, okay? But even God at times allow the natural cause to take its place, not just by prayer. They check the CVs, they check your work experience. Now, at the end of the day, they discover that you operate clean, also operate for it. You operate great for it and excavator. Are you getting me now? You look at yourself. Hello? What of you wonder why you're speaking that here? Because you are just like an embodiment of so many things in one, that if my attention have those machines on ground, you can just say, I really like, please go and carry that excavator from the person, bring it down to this little bed, you want to take it out. Are you getting me now? They are looking for those they want to use to do so many work. It will not happen like that. Okay? It will not happen like that. But let's treat our topic first. We are going to diagnose this. You see, management of Equilog 1 not using one word. That's it is a procedure. Yeah, I always say that because I think it's a system I have been into and I'm so used to it. And I don't like putting it here if I'm teaching you something. Yeah, grain is a complicated equipment and it can be intimidating. The size, the height, the sound. Now, if you want to be an operator, one character you need to have, you need to be bold to become a grain operator. Yeah. Do you know what? Have you seen dual grain before? Yeah. If you see where they mount some dual grain behind some stratosphere, those tall buildings, you see, you'll be asking yourself, is there a creator who planned that place? Yes, I'm a creator. So you want me to ask a lot of one museum. Okay? If you have a phobia of height, you need to do that. But the kind of creator I'm operating is on top of the water. Okay? Like the harbor crane. It's marine crane now. Okay? They create a platform, they install some of them come with the vessel. Why some of them, they are short rings, they bring, okay? That's where the setup comes in. Set the battery, that's bring back the pad, the test. So they set the limits and everything. Everything I'm going to teach you, check maybe your Google dictionary. Okay, you see that down? Some people have the water phobia. When they climb, they are always at the water. But it's not that everybody's around the water, they won't concentrate. The attention is going to be like, you know, are you getting that? So you need to be very bold. You need to just ignore those distractions and get focused on your work. And if you are confident with anything, even if you are not perfect with it, they will love you for it.
that with time, this guy will improve. I used to be a very careful person.
Yeah.
Before I got the opportunity to become a real golden opportunity, and I'm like, this one cannot grow. Okay? I don't recommend, it wasn't as easy as I thought. We had a rigorous challenge. But because I was courageous, I was determined, I was bold, I conquered. Yeah, I conquered. Within a few months, I conquered very well. And I didn't stop there. There are people we started with, okay? Some of them today, they will come and they will be like, oh, man, God, they are paying you well. Highest you give to them, 10, 20 million. And it's not going to be every now. That is why we just need to do what? Get ourselves equipped. No knowledge is a waste. I was telling one of the instructors, one of my children, my son, now 14 years old, I said I was going to bring him to do, what do you call it, the lifting operation to learn how to operate. He operated 4 kilos. He's as good as I am with 4 kilos. The daddy took him somewhere in Africa to advise him. I'm not saying you should walk, but you just watch this book. And you get what I'm saying? And he's still going to do more. What am I bringing in? You see, in Nigeria, when the father sees that this profession is paying, he's there. He does what he brings his children, right? That's why I'm bringing my own children all in the mechanical land as well to see how they are. Though they have their choices, but no knowledge is waste. No knowledge is waste. Let's get down to business. Point set up. And stability. We're going to define it. Well, I used to tell them in my classes, those is when they give us subjects in school. The reason why most of us don't understand the subject is because we don't work with understanding. We don't try to check the meaning of those things from the dictionary and actually know how they expand the world and get the nuggets of it. But I want to go into this. What is a crony? You have seen a crane. How can you define that machine? Above my definition, it's not anything from any book or anywhere. It's just what I know. How I saw it. You want to try it? Your terms, even if you have dictionary terms, just say it. I don't even know dictionary terms.
The crane is a type of machine that is generally equipped. Machines, wires, hoists, and shoes for heavy materials on the horizontal.
Thank you. Somebody has one of you with that. You are very much, in line. I wrote here, is a machine or an equipment that does the lifting of objects. You want to write it, please? What is a crane? It is a machine or an equipment. It is a machine or equipment that does the lifting of objects, substance, or materials within the range of its capacity. You have to specify. My word. A crane is a machine or equipment that does the lifting of objects, substance, or materials within the range of its capacity, rotating on a 360-degree axis. You read it? I am not writing. What happened?
It's for 4 kids.
Oh, okay, it's a plus in the class.
You are really blessed though.
But, this is. Okay, yeah, as is. You read as is. A crane is a machine or equipment that does the lifting of objects, substance, or materials within the range of its capacity. On a 360-degree axis. Have you written that? Have you done? Now, if you check this definition, it's highly analytical. Let me use that word.
He has achieved more from what you define.
Cleansing distance.
Thank you. You know, some definitions, they can just match into so many things. Right? You just have to specific. Because if you understand the nuggets of what you are defining, then you know the purpose, how to use it. Okay? That queen does not just leave things. He leaves things within its capacity. Are you getting me now? That's where in the model. Every queen, you will see some queens. Yeah, you see some queens, there are 30 tons. Right? You have them 60. Like that, you know, 120, you know, 200, and so forth and so forth. You have queen of different capacity. Now, it depends on the load that you want to give. That is the crane you are going to apply. You will not apply the crane of 30 tons to the load of almost 100 tons or 200. No, you won't apply that. You know, because they show you some accidents, right? Okay. You guys watched accidents on video. This gets like this class. There was this machine I used to offer. He said, you're resilient. That machine is a deadly machine. Very sweet, very sweet, very fine. But if you are careless with it, if it doesn't kill you, that means it's going to destroy some part of the body, definitely. They call it vodka, small shots. It has force to push it through that. You go there, through that. So imagine when that machine does not meant to push the velocity of the speed of the machine, the way it runs. So if you get into a bump, it jumps through. It's going to jump, hit your head on the road. So you have to belt down, you know, before you start. Or you will press at the speed. That's it. You see my thing, you check my phone now. Where is my phone? Where's my phone? Yeah. Okay. I think you see me inside this inside of this machine. Sure. Don't mind, I like them teaching with groups. You know, Africans are very hard to come in, I mean. Where is this machine? It's called Bobcat. You see that it's not preparing. Sure you see them? It's not preparing. But they brought it and I saw it and I liked it. And sometimes I don't want to dodge duty. That year we dodged it. I want this book as well. I'm just going to hide. I have so many of it here. I just can't. Okay, this is the book cut. If you look at it, but yeah, exam. I mean, this. Where is that mesh now? Huh? Is it mesh? I see this mesh. Yeah. That this is book cut. The book cut inside. So you can see, right? That the man that operates is not just lecturing on this thing. So a crane is a machine that does a lifting of objects, substance, or materials within the range of its capacity on a 360-degree axis. It returns all round. It moves round. You must understand the crane. Why is that with capacity? We are going to something. Crane setup and stability. There are some persons who are professional operators, but truly they didn't study it well, or out of negligence, they have caused so much accident to human lives, properties, and even the machine itself. Okay? So what you are doing right now, put your mind, I hope all of us have a clear eye vision. Because if you are an operator, you must have clear eye vision and good hearing, aid or whatever. Hearing ability. Yeah. You know, and you must be good in communicating. It's an organized operation. When you are doing it, everybody is together to just lift one thing. That was the teaching on lifting plan. Have you ever heard that before? Okay. When you want to lift some a subject or a substance, they have to plan it. Everybody gets to the office, they begin to plan the surface. The terrain, the atmosphere. We'll get to that. Let's go. Okay, what is setup? What is setup? Because I'm breaking these things down so that we can understand it. What is setup? In your own terms, it's just what we know. What is setup? Nobody sent me up.
He set me up. No, what is set up? Okay, I'll bring it up here. It simply means to arrange or to make up, assembling together to form a unit. I'll read it for you now. It simply means to arrange. To arrange. Or make up. Assembling together to form a unit. Assembling together to form a unit. Now, I'll tell you why they have set up the brain. From your definition, you tried. But the thing I'm going to tell you, the brain itself does not carry everything it takes to function. They have to assemble them together. For instance, you have seen that something like this. Divine. This is a marker they want carrying. Yeah? It's a mask down on his mask. Something. I don't know if you see that. What was this? Who can just tell what this? Is a tower crane. Is a tower crane. This is the cabin where the people sits down. This crane, you have no bed that will transport all the parts of this crane to the site where it's going to work. Okay? So the process of assembling it together is what? That process. And when you want to set this up, something is required. A lot is required. Apart from professional personnel, you will require a motorized crane. The one that has the people. That's going to do all these liftings before they tie it. Okay? And this setup is carried out by what we call riggers. Who know they are? Sorry.
Riggers.
I think they are riggers as well. So that's where the whole setup comes in. So you see that most cranes, they don't have their full compartment to function. Even the mobile crane itself, there are some chairs, we call them chairs, G-E-A-R-O-S, that they have to bring with truck by the riggers to the site of work and begin to tie and loose. They will change wires, inspect wires. All that process is simply what?
Set up.
Okay, let's get it.
So, basically, you're saying that
the assembled screen.
The assembled screen.
They are called riggers. Yes, they are called riggers. See, why you are learning this now is this. A rigger is not a crane operator. But a crane operator is what? It's a rigger. Yeah. Riggers are, they are jobs. Fine. Okay?
How long ago?
Well, crane operators will not riggers jobs. Are you getting me now? Because as an operator, why do you need to know what the rigger does? There are some riggers, they are so inexperienced that after setting up a crane for you and you want to operate that crane, if you don't know anything, you start having problems with the crane. And when any damage occurs, you face the problem, the query, you answer the query. Because they'll ask you, say, no, I just go operate it, you need a nice setup. So you don't. You didn't expect it because as an operator, if I want to operate any crane now, this is what we'll do in the morning. When I get to work and I'm assigned to go and work at about 6, 7, 8 or wherever the designation they assigned it to. When I want to pick up the crane, I will observe the crane. First of all, the floor level, everything, is it intact? Then when I start the crane, I'm not going to move immediately. I begin to raise the woman, I'm going to question, but your colleague, they cause more damage on ground for you before you come. And behind it, now please have a change and go home. So when you start walking and something happens, you say, well, let me meet one. Understand? The fault was discovered under your care. Abi. So you face the consequence now. So when you have change, you say, something went wrong. You pick up your radio. Radio is under this screen. Something very wrong, so you do that. Say, I beg, then they come check and say, something happened. They will drive down and begin to spend that we're talking about. They will not call the person who has already gone to call, what happened to this screen? What do you use and need? This wire is kinking already, you don't need to see it, where are you getting me now? So let him now begin. It's okay, don't worry, when you come to the office. So now they will not tell you to pack this one, crane number 7, carry crane 15, go and walk with that one. Are you getting me? That's why I'm a professor. You need to know more about reading as well. So that when you read that made any mistake, it will not lead to your own adverse effects. Are we communicating? Stability. What does it mean? You sometimes they say that this word, we know now, teacher, leave on. Comes to your mind, says to fairness. Right? That's it. To have a firm or stable grip. In Ukraine terms, stability, to have firm or stable grip. To do one time, long ago. I don't know the first time I remember. I think we remember that the time, first time, God bombs, that bridge area, cars, God bombs. It was on the news, right? And the bridge was affected. And later they had to rebuild the bridge. Okay? I was privileged in one of the persons that went there to do one or two things. We brought the grain to the site to work. No, there's a river there. While we're trying to set up the grain, we need to get a firm surface to put our battery on. So along the line, one of the legs actually began to say, you know, though he feels, I don't know too much. You know, Moses now. But then, there are things I normally do. When you are with someone, don't tell the person, you know, or you know, you understand, just you may even learn more. So I accidentally bring myself in the world. But the guy was talking, he also has seen that this man that is using this kind of language know about this. So I told him, I said, this outrigger, this bag, you are to take it off, help that place when you place the bag. He said, why? I said, this place got bombs. And even the soil texture has lost its strength. Okay? And the way I stepped now, the case seems to be sinking. He said, no, he said, he lifts it. He was looking at his direction. I said, no matter what, once you lift anything, just like I am, right? Once I lift something and my leg does not feel the weight of what I lift. So he doubted it. And I have to keep quiet. I'm not even pretending it. I'm just getting too much. We took the slab, the one to give the edge of the bridge. Very mighty, Lord, those long everyone. Immediately he turned. That's what I told him. I don't judge him. He was even lucky, he has not raised him up that much. He had twisted him upside down. So they said, hey, you know, I'm going to have it, your son. And he lowered the load. He said, you talk up. And me, I played deaf here that time. You understand? You know when you don't have credit, you talk about it. After I said he didn't talk to me, I kept news. Are you getting me now? Those are the things you put into consideration before you use. The stableness of the platform for your lifts. Even all those things you see when you want to mount them. Okay? Stability is required. After they set the whole thing, they will check the terrain and they will make sure every load this extension is going to carry. You know, you have something like this here. Something like that has a hook that they let down to meet the load. You see that? There's a counterweight behind this place. Am I correct? Heavy metals. The counterweight.
Thank you. All is under stability. So whatever you are lifting must not exceed this cancer wound. Because if it does, it's going to break this, and this is going to hit the tower house. Okay, and crush the operator inside of it. So as an operator, you should know the weight of your load that you're also going to lift. All those things matter. You don't just come and begin to climb the stairs up and enter your cabin. But I would have really used to the same place, it's okay. It will actually manifest. Okay? You are carrying about 60 slabs and each one is 15 tons. So you want the green. It's not the green, it's the right tons. But we're not doing a twin lifting. Like sometimes, if you put three together, make the work fast. 45. Have you? Can 45 tons crane carry 45 tons of load? Yes or no? No, sir. A crane cannot carry the load equivalent to the same tons. You know, you can't take it. If you are carrying 50 tons, maybe use 120 or 100. Because there are lots of crane that is not part of my talking, but let me just throw it to it. Maybe just you guys. Okay, I've taught them here before. If the crane is 100 tons, okay, now I'll describe something like this. Like this is the cabin house. There are some crane like this, whatever. You have the screen there in the van. Show me that thing. Okay, beautiful. Don't let me to draw. You see the screen? This is 100 tons now. Okay. Is anyone has done it? Okay, see this one. When the screen is 100 tons, when it lifts the load, even close to itself, it's very balanced. When maybe the screen begins to extend, what happens?
It's in the shades.
The same thing with us now. If I'm carrying a dumbbell like this, I can hold it for like 20 minutes. But when I come this way, you see my hand what? It has reduced the capacity of
my strength. So with distance, you can say
yes, with distance, it's going to reduce your crane. The load becomes in charge. Okay? Alright, we'll stick on. Why set up a crane? Why set up a crane? Why do you set up a crane? Why do you set up a crane? Why set up a crane? To form a unit for effective lifting operation. To form a unit. To form a unit. For effective lifting operation and reducing the chances of any occurrence of hazards, to form a unit for effective lifting operation and reducing the chances of any occurrence of hazards during lifting operations. To form a unit for effective lifting operation and reduce the chances of any occurrence of hazards during the operation. You see, I feel like my definitions, if you check your listing, is different, but it's very similar. Lifting operation. Setup is always required in every lifting operation. For instance, if we take 30 tons crane to do some job, maybe the next job we want to do, we still require to change the gears to fit in for that lift. So setup is always necessary. He said, no, you just can't already, just can't go. Fine. There are sometimes when you come to like, okay, the crane setup, you discover that you even have nothing or less to do. That what you want to do is almost equivalent. But it is necessary, you must cross-check during any setup. Okay, during the lifting operation, you must cross-check. Because that might be one of the things you change. There are sometimes when you are walking, nothing is going to go wrong. What is going to go wrong? There is this hook. Where is the hook? Where is that hook? The van. The hook here, the hook. Show me the hook.
On the chain.
I'll show you something. No, not this one. This one's Baba. Just shameful. You know it's like this. Don't worry. The guy always has time. It's always like this. Okay, fine. Thank you. This is what I'm looking for. You see the difference? There are some lifting you must have done. You use this one to set you. If you want to do another lifting, what you just need to change there is just maybe put this one. I know. Because why? If you use the same one, I've seen where this thing, if you stretch like ruler, this one, just stretch out. Every other jazz, the turns are correct. But this one is the only wrong one there. So you see the load just stretch down out, and it's going to destroy the load. Are you getting that? So it is necessary during any operation, you must come for a set of cross check. Which one doesn't feel so good?
So,
They have this thing, tongues written on them, some they are stamped. Some are stickers, okay, metal stickers, tagged to it like a tag line, short. You just see. So, when you get the jazz store, where you have the form, there are sometimes, don't even let them come, you just drive down there and tell them, give me 15. Okay? Right, what are the requirements for great setup and stability? What are the requirements? Not just anybody, but anyhow, what are the requirements? Number one. Professional personnel called readers. Professional personnel called readers. This is their job. Professional personnel called readers must be on ground during any print setup. Professional personnel called readers must be on ground during any print setup to determine the right jazz or equipment for such lifting operation. Are we together? Operation. What are the requirements for crane setup and stability? Professional personnel called riggers must be on ground during any crane setup to determine the right jazz or equipment for such lifting operations. We got that right?
Yes.
Two. An experienced operator. On good eyesight. To cross-examine the setup. And jazz. And also to test run the plants. We call it plants. That's the crane. Before applying it for any meeting, to test run the plant, the crane, before applying it for any meeting. Hello?
Did you get the definition?
No. Very necessary, very important that when any situation takes place, an operator has to be on ground. Okay? To do what? Like I said, if you want to examine everything thoroughly, if you want to start the grid, if you want to do a minor test run, it may not be the one to use the grid to work, but to be rest assured that what the leaders have done is in place. And to come back to the office and say, this grid is good for the job today. Okay? So you need them there. Any person don't just do that grid setup. It requires the reader. And it's as important as that. Okay? Because the reader, they are trained personnel to do such. They understand the nitty-gritty of what you know, they are doing. It's not just anybody saying, okay, because I've seen it, I have my description now. I don't know how to cook. Okay? Yeah, give me all the ingredients. Right? I think I went to my friend's house once and they were sick. You know, I saw very well. I think I was so hungry. And that environment, I don't know where to buy something. So I went to the kitchen and saw Indomie, saw Misha, so.
I told my wife to swim, my wife laughed. No, I went to the beach and I brought the Indomie and break it. I didn't think because I know Indomie is not rice, so I forgot. And I put it like water, like, I just put rice. Because okay. What? So, as I was boiling, I came and checked it. I don't know what else to do. I just put to the dishes and put inside and cut that space. It's funny. If I find something, I was not going to dry the water. I didn't know that. No rice to dry. So to dry. Sometimes why? Because everything water is down, I've been dead and normal. So I brought it in. It looks like cake. Nobody could eat it. I have to like pour that inside the guy
and dispose it.
What am I trying to say? Whether it's not your job, you can't get it right. Caterers know how to do those things. Like my wife, she's a caterer. Everyone was asking where she traveled. I don't think that's the issue. I grew up in a home where you have the females doing everything, so I was not opportunity to like, okay, see how they do the food. One or two things. I know people who are good food. I eat soup.
Yes.
Like I think I'm going to eat now. I know good food. Okay. So, I messed up. You know, like if anything close to cooking, if there's a talk, I will just say, okay. So, what am I trying to say? This same crane you are seeing, there are people who are built like me, who went to the kitchen, who doesn't have to cook with crane. Yes. You have them. In the company, they said there is always a wire hose, there's always a chain, bring them together, they begin to assemble. Okay? Now, when accident occurs, all these guys will hide. Which one? That's when you know that my ghost like to do things that I know. Sometimes my ghost like to come in, like in my house, something will lose. And David, Lee, Victor, that is not me, I didn't see it. Let's go to the next.
Serious
ghost. That's why you know it was a ghost that came to do the setup of the grid. So when it happens like that, everybody begins to hide. Nobody wants to answer the query. Are you getting me now? So if you have any job to do, every company have their we call them foreman. They are the ones that you go prepare the place ahead. They are the riggers. We call them company, go to the bedding place. Every company have them. Just call. They will take it up. prepare the place, prepare the job, then the operator will now inspect what they have done. All this is to avoid what accidents, to avoid damage, destruction of property. Okay? Now, beautiful. In setup, there's another thing that is also considered. Okay? Also, before any crane setup, you must consider the operation location. Purpose. And why? Okay. And things you will take to do your setup at the site. You cannot just travel all the way from one state to another for the job with all the jobs, and when you get it, it's not required. You travel back again. So you have to inquire. There is one job here, I don't know if you can. They called me, I was from an engineer, so I called the engineer, we got the crane and the peasants, you know. Look what they will even give to the site. I'll ask all the questions I need to ask. You know, like, I want to tell you, I said, yes. If I won't mobilize, I think I pay money come for nothing. No, that's it. If you want to write it, fine. All the questions I asked, we got everything right. We knew the things we carry out for the job. It's a decent treasure. We want to lift it on a low bed and carry it to their seashore where they use it for their dredging room. Are you getting me now? So, before any sense of, you must consider the operation location. This is very important, as it will determine the distance and height setting limits of your home. Okay? Maybe the area is waterlogged area, wire environment, stormy atmosphere. Okay? Now, there are some environments.
Stick on your plan.
Yeah?
Stick on your plan. Where does your plan? Stick on your plan.
Yeah, it's a standard question of yes. It does part of it, it's not a requirement. I'm just giving you a tip. I'm running over it. Now, there are some job you want to do. It's part experience over the years. Railway, you know, railway, right? Because sometimes, apart from the company I work, I do my personal. In the screen, there. They come for a job at the way, so we went there. What happened? A truck was carrying one load and loads left side load and block the full express. No going, no more, no coming. So when they called for the job, you know, I quickly rushed and said, I rushed like this. When I called it, you know, everyone would look at what I'm managing at the day like a bad day like this. They don't understand what I was doing. I was walking around. You know, the crane, the debris, the wire, because they are lab, see NEPA wire. See, if you are a careless operator, you will just die for nothing. Take the job, sweep the job, take, but you don't have good thinking, you don't have experience. Some operators will carry their boom and put on an electric pole. Say it's a mistake, yeah? A mistake, keep person, don't be say that. And because you don't know which one is a mistake, go back. This is a mistake. You can see touch electric. Have you seen that one? See, go back. If you don't go, you don't go. Now, what is it? So, you have to be very careful. So, I was there, I started checking. So many wires. In fact, that won't even increase your chance of charging anybody if you have that kind of job. Okay. So, I was looking at people. Now, when that job was done, the young operator had been really professional. He knows the guy, he said his business. Very, very professional. It was a sensitive job as he was operating. The signal people need to tell him, hold on, boom up, low. Okay? To your left, a little, hold on. Voice down your rope. Are you getting me now? Because of the wires. In that terrain. That one is even more dangerous. But there are most times big companies will call the power authorities and okay, there is a sense of what we need to do here because even maybe their staff will slip out to do the roadblock. I mean, so if you want that to be taken off the road, if you wish I can, you said you leave and drive home, find more small or something, you have a sleep with you for a meal. And whenever you're tired, they say, I really want to operate this. Now,
sometimes we call the positive, switch the area off totally. It's like, peradventure, you mistakenly touch it, you will not be electrocuted to death. Okay? But when you don't have that, but there are some others too. You know when you call Nigeria Leper, very wicked country. When you call them, and they discover saying, I'm going to this church, I said, okay, we'll go up and we'll give you something now. Instead of protecting lives first, forget the love. Our system. So when you give us something, I give us something. He didn't tell the Christians, 200. We'll give it to the organ, 300. What is good for me and people? What is it? I said, you want to do something with it now. So off farm, he said. Because if I didn't leave that like 1 week, that's not bad. Okay? Then stormy atmosphere. When the wind is high, that sometimes when you are doing some lifting in an area that is stormy, you know, you have to do it in a very simple manner. Even if it's required of you most times, and you stop. Okay? When the weather is normal, I know my time is up, and I'm not the waste time. Hello? So when the weather is normal, you can continue, you know, because it's better to be safe than what? Very, very important. So if you have questions to ask, I will be to entertain at least from all of us. Regarding our teaching so far, just ask questions. Don't ask me chemistry, don't ask me physics, ask me pretty much.
I'm still having one to so you said we can't must have given you the information about the power banks in the how do you do that as the operator get to know it?
Let me give you one very, very quick mathematics. It's very, very simple. Okay? Not all loads, they will write the weight. Okay? Now, I want to read a container that contains this chair, like 300 pieces. Are you getting that? What is simply the weight of one of these chips? Just the weight. Times what? 300 pieces. What is the weight of the container itself added to it? And that is probably like almost about 20,000 kilograms. Okay? Which is how many tons?
20
tons. So you know that your crane is 15 tons. And your crane is 15 tons. Your bucket is even 15 tons. You don't go near it. I hope you don't figure go to somewhere else, check for it. Okay? It's very simple. There are some things you see you just value. Now, there are some lifting also, you may not be able to value the tonnage. Though some of them, you wrote it with something marked out pen
around.
So, there are some that I won't be able to get to it. When I bring my crane close to such people, they don't do swift lifting. Just pick up from now. You try. Okay? When you try, you'll see the rest of your brain. Have you seen those funny times look? How they used to carry this with these shouts, they used to shout. Mm-hmm. Yeah? That shout is not shakara. You know that? It's an applied force. Crane has an applied force. When crane is able to form here, it's almost evident in capacity. You will know from the sound. You will see now. You see the crane even jerking from a very low height. You see the crane now. You know, but it's capacity. You know you have to be able to lift and carry. Okay. So there, are, you still try such like that. It's not everything that you're not right. I'm not going to carry.
No, I want to ask you a question.
Okay.
I've passed through some experiences.
What do you operate?
No, I'm a safety officer.
Okay.
Now, is it comfortable for you to work from a batch? Let's say for instance, Your crane is about 150 tons, and what you're about to carry is about 90 tons, and the space, there's not enough land space, so you're moving through the water to transport from this point to the other point. So is he advising you for you to walk on the barge?
Your question is very strict, and like me, we've done that several times. I walk on the barge. Even tonight, I suspect, because I'm leaving, you check my bag and I told you, you see my safety shoe inside my bag. I'm leaving here straight to water, I'm going to my house. Okay? You see, the barge is a platform on the water. Okay? And you bring either your collar away.
So maybe they don't know the barge. You should show them.
Yeah,
do you know what a barge is?
Barge. Mm-hmm. It's always on water. You don't understand the barge. Yeah? You drive this into a barge and set your outriggers on it. Okay?
Yes, sir.
But before then, they fill the barge with water, I hope you know that, to give it weight. Give it weight. Are you getting it now?
Yeah.
This is the barge. It's just a platform on the water because the things we stand there to walk. So what we do sometimes, they will double the barge. Are you getting me now? And some of these things you see, if you want to use them to work, they are able to balance. If it's close to the land, they will anchor the barge out so that the adverse force, okay, will not tumble into something. And as the barge is working, you also have to see yourself on top of the barge observing the movement of what you are doing. Are you getting me now? If there's anything that is not too comfortable, they halt the operation. Okay, the labor must for that day will take it for 1 hour and show the test. What do we, this is not safe because it is not good to risk any beating. Not safe, never good. Am I correct? Yes, does that answer your question?
Yes.
Thank you. So please, any more questions? All right. If we don't have any more questions, we'll call it a day and then God bless you, Richard. Thank you.